Pleasant morning to all of you, all my dear children. Am I audible to you all? Okay, thank you. Thank you, my dear children. Okay, so we were looking into the revision part of unit 1, right? Unit 1 prose, we are going through it. So we have looked at the synonyms and antonyms. Now we are looking into the short answers, right? Quickly, let me share the screen for y'all. I hope the screen sharing is visible to all my dear children. The honest man activity should be posted in the Google form. I hope so. Plenty of you all have posted it. If at all you all haven't done it, please do it as early as possible. Yes. Maybe we can give you all 1 or 2 days. 1 day is more than enough. Hardly it is going to take only 10 minutes for you all to do it. So please do it as early as possible. Okay. We are there with the question number 4, right? We have seen up to question number 4. What sort of conversation did Ajit and Sachin had while traveling? So what was the answer? Ajit and Sachin had the conversation about the nuances of batting while traveling. So what is nuances? Small tricks. Okay. So Ajit and Sachin always had a conversation that was only about nuances of batting while they traveled from Bandra to Shivaji Park. Okay. Very good, my dear children. Okay. What routine did Sachin follow in washing clothes? What was the routine? What did he follow daily? Routine means following something daily. See here, Sachin. His routine was to wash his clothes as soon as he had returned from the morning session. Okay. So what will be his routine? So he will wash his clothes as soon as he returns from the morning session. You can even add, if you're very creative enough, you can even add, and after the evening session, he goes home and washes the cricketing clothes once again and wears it the next morning. So you'll needn't go until that. My dear children, you can simply write this one. Sachin's routine was to wash his clothes as soon as he had returned from the morning session. Is the answer. Is there any doubt with the answer, my dear children? Is it easy enough? Definitely, it is going to be easy only, I guess. Okay. What did Achreka inform Ajit? What Achreka told Ajit? So this one. See, this lesson, the entire lesson, y'all would have understood it very clearly. So that's not going to be that hard for y'all, I guess. See, Achreka informed Ajit that Sachin had the potential to be a good cricketer if he practiced all year around. Okay, so that is the answer. What did Achreka say to Ajit? So he informed Ajit that Sachin had all the potentials to be a good cricketer, but this 2 months practice alone is not going to be enough. He has to practice all year or 365 days, he has to practice daily to become the best cricketer. So this is what Achreka informed Ajit. Is there any doubts, my dear children? Okay, question number 7. What was the suggestion given by Achreka to Sachin's father? So Achreka suggested something, no, to Sachin's father. What did he say? The suggestion given by Achreka to Sachin's father was to change the school. So Achreka gave Sachin's father a suggestion that Sachin has to change his school. Why? What is the reason? Because the previous school where he was studying was the New English School. It did not have any cricketing facility. So that's why
Achrekar
asked Sachin's father to change Sachin's school. Okay, I hope you all understand it. What acted as a safety wall? What acted as a safety wall for Sachin Tendulkar? Sachin's all excess energies were getting channeled into cricket, which acted as a kind of safety wall. So all his excess energy, additional energy, everything got channeled, got groomed into cricket, which acted as a kind of safety valve. So anyway, he's going to become the best cricketer. So that's the safety valve which they say here. Are you clear with this page, Ma? Question number 1 to 8 is there on your screen. If at all you have any doubt, please post your doubt. I'll give you 1 minute time. After that, I will change pages. When I change page, definitely I will not answer any doubts. Make it fast. Any doubt regarding any question? Fine. Okay, that's okay. So let's move on to question number 9. So this shows how much you all are grasping towards the lesson. You all are doing it so beautiful, my dear children. Okay. What did Sachin do during the 30-minute break? What will he do during the 30-minute break from 4:30 to 5? During the 30-minute break, Sachin would go and have a vada pav. It's very simple, no? We keep every edible in our mind, right? Whichever we eat, we will keep it in our mind. So during the 30-minute break, Sachin would go and have a vada pav. So that's the answer. Okay. What is the intense 15 minutes mentioned here? So the last 15 minutes, no? So from 6:45 to 7, Sachin had a intense coaching. What is it? See, towards the last 15 minutes, every bowler in the camp would come and bowl to Sachin with some 60 to 70 boys fielding. He should survive those intense 15 minutes without getting out. So this is the 15 minutes which is recorded here, right? So what is it? The last 15 minutes, all the bowlers in the camp will come and bowl at Sachin with 60 to 70 fielders in the ground. And Sachin's prime aim was to survive that 15 minutes without getting out. Is that clear, my dear children? Okay, question number 11. What did Sachin's father do just to make Sachin happy? What did he do to make Sachin happy? Sachin's father would invariably end up giving him what he wanted just to see him happy. So Sachin's father will give anything for him to make Sachin happy. See, he wanted to change the school. Yes, go for it. He wanted fruit cocktail. Yes, go for it. So that's how it goes up, right? So Sachin's father would invariably end up giving him what he wanted. Whichever Sachin Tendulkar wanted, Sachin's father gave him just to see him happy. Okay. So that's what we just given there. Okay. What did embarrass Sachin in the bus? What made Sachin be embarrassed? Embarrassed means shameful. Okay. What was the thing, shameful act in the bus? See, the conductors were often rude. Possibly conductors, because of their business, they'll always be standing the whole day. They'll be sweating and soaking. So always they are going to be rude. They have to be like that. And would sometimes ask Sachin to buy 2 tickets. What the conductors will do? They are very rude and they would sometimes ask Sachin to buy 2 tickets. And this, no, in front of the others, if they ask that Sachin has money only to buy 1 ticket, what is he going to do? He will feel very shameful. So it embarrassed him in the bus. This is the incident which embarrassed Sachin Tendulkar in the bus. See, the conductors were often rude and would sometimes ask Sachin to buy 2 tickets. So this embarrassed him in the bus. Okay. So question number 13. What made Sachin forget to go to the nets? Sometimes he forgets to go to the nets, no? What is the reason for it? See, the fun of playing with friends at home made Sachin forget to go to nets. He wanted to play with his friends at home. So sometimes he will forget to go to the nets. Okay. Next question. What was Coach Achrekar's first impression on Sachin? Did he really select him in the first instance? No. See, he was too young to make the camp. Sachin was too young to make the camp. This was the first impression of Achrekar on Sachin. Okay. So he was 11 years old, very short. So Achrayka thought he is very young to come to the camp. So that was his first impression. Okay, next one. Why did Sachin feel that the schedule of the camp was rigorous? Rigorous means what? Very hard. Why? See here. After practice, Sachin would be exhausted by the end of the day. So he felt that the schedule of the camp was rigorous. After the practice, early morning when it starts at 6, it ends at 7 in the evening, Sachin will totally be drained out. He will be totally tired. That's why he felt that the schedule was very rigorous. Are you able to understand, my dear children, until this? Any doubts, ma? Any doubts, my dear children? Okay. What did serve as a very personal coaching manual to Sachin? What was Sachin's personal coaching manual? See, a note that his brother Ajit gave to him containing some thoughts about batting. And it served as a very personal coaching manual to Sachin. A note which was given by Ajit, you know, Ajit, his brother, has given a note in which he has some thoughts about batting. So something about batting is there. So it served as a personal coaching manual to Sachin Tendulkar. Is that understood, my dear children? Okay, next one. Why was Sachin asked to change the school? Why was he asked to change the school? Sachin's school did not have cricket facilities. Sachin's school, which school? The New English School did not have any cricketing facility. So he was asked to change schools if he wanted to pursue cricket seriously. If he wanted to follow cricket seriously, he had to change school. That was the reason for Sachin changing the school. Okay. Next question. What was the condition laid down by Sachin's father for changing the school? What was the only condition which Sachin's father said? See, Sachin should be really serious about playing cricket. Was the only condition laid by Sachin's father for changing the school. What Sachin's father said, Sachin must be very serious in play about playing cricket. He should not take it as a play. He has to take it as his ambition or goal. That was the only condition which was laid by Sachin's father. Is there any doubts, my dear children? Any doubts? I couldn't get your chats, ma. Okay. Here I'm getting it. Very good. No doubt. Fine. Very good. Okay. The next one. How did the act with the 1 rupee coin help Sachin become a good cricketer? That 1 rupee coins act, no? Achrayka would place the stump, no? The 1 rupee coin on the stump, no? How did it make Sachin become a good cricketer? See, the act with the 1 rupee coin taught Sachin how to concentrate even when physically drained. Even when you're totally tired, you should not give up your game. That is the one lesson which this 1 rupee coin has helped Sachin to become a good cricketer. Okay. The act with the 1 rupee coin has taught Sachin how to concentrate even when you're physically drained. Even when you're tired, you have to focus on your game. That's what the 1 rupee coin taught Sachin. And that's why he became a good cricketer. Okay. What did help Sachin to build his physical and mental stamina? What were the incidents which made Sachin build his physical and mental stamina? See, the routine of the camp that Sachin repeated right through his summer holidays helped him to build up physical and mental stamina. The routine. Daily, Sachin had to repeat what? Whatever he has done in the summer holiday. That helped him to build up physical and mental stamina. Okay. Which incident triggered the coach to be angry on Sachin? And what incident Sachin's coach became angry on Sachin? See here. Once Sachin bunked his daily evening class to watch an inter-school cricket match, not anticipating that sir would be there. So once what happened, he cut the coaching class, he went to watch an inter-school cricket match in the school. He thought Achrayka sir is not going to be there, but Achrayka was there. And this incident triggered the coach to be angry on Sachin. At that particular time only, Achrayka became very angry on Sachin Tendulkar. Okay? Why do you think Achrayka punished Sachin. Why did Achrekar punish Sachin? I think Achrekar punished Sachin because he was not aware of his potential. So Sachin was not at all aware of his potential because he had the potentiality of playing for Indian team. So that's why, in order to, he hasn't understood the potential. He did not understand the skill which he had. That's why Achrekar punished Sachin. Okay. I owe myself to him. What does Sachin mean here? This phrase, with this this sentence, what does it explain to us? See, Sachin means that without Achrekar, he would not be the cricketer he turned out to be. If it weren't Achrekar, Sachin wouldn't have become such a great cricketer. So that's what this phrase says. Is there any doubt with this page, my dear children? Now see, from question number 9 to 17, I have placed it on the screen. You can just go through it, my dear children. If you have any doubts, you might ask. I'll give you 1 minute time because everything is explained there. I think this lesson is going to be very easy for y'all. And it is the first lesson, I guess, right? Okay, from question number 18 to 23. Fine. Shall we move on to the next page, my dear children? Right. So with that, the short answers are over. So totally there are 23. Don't worry. Whichsoever short answer is asked within the book also, you all have to be very ready. Ready enough to write it. Okay. There are two paragraphs to be learned. Achrekar was a sincere coach. Substantiate. Prove it. Always, when you're writing the paragraph, my dear children, please listen with your ears wide open. So this is the rule of how to write a paragraph. See, you have to write the title there, name of the author and theme. So these things are very important, my dear children. Title is Learning the Game. Author is Sachin Tendulkar. And theme is Farsightedness of a Coach. Okay. Then you're going to write the paragraph. In between, you're going to give some textual quotation. From the text, the quotation has to be there. So these are very important. See, Sachin Tendulkar, in his autobiography, says that Achrekar was the man who shaped his cricketing career. So what is Sachin Tendulkar saying in his autobiography? So he says Achrekar was the man who has shaped his cricketing career. If it was not Achrekar, Tendulkar wouldn't have imprinted his marks in the history of cricket. If at all it wasn't Achrekar, definitely Sachin wouldn't have become an international cricket player. Ramkant Achrekar was a cricket coach in Shardashram Vidya Mandir in Mumbai. What was the profession of Ramkant Achrekar? He was a cricket coach in Shardashram Vidya Mandir, a school in Mumbai. He ran summer camp too. Where did he run the summer camp? He ran the summer camp at the Shivaji Park. He agreed to let Sachin join the summer camp. So initially he resisted, but later looking at the batting talent of Sachin Tendulkar, he agreed Sachin to join his summer camp. He identified the potential of Sachin to be a good cricketer. So he identified the hidden talent of Sachin Tendulkar becoming a good cricketer. So what did he do? He suggested Sachin's father to change his school. So he asked Sachin's father to change school from New English School to Shardashram Vidya Mandir. His act with the 1 rupee coin taught Sachin how to concentrate even when physically drained. Okay. So the 1 rupee coin, no, it played a very important role in Sachin's life. Even when you're totally drained, you have to focus on the game. That is the lesson which the 1 rupee coin has taught. Okay. Look at the textual quote which is given there. Don't waste your time playing insane game with these kids. So these are the words exactly said by Achrekar. What did he say to Tendulkar? He said, don't waste your time playing insane games, childish game, kiddish game with these kids. Cricket is waiting for you at the net. Your game is the cricket ball game. Practice hard and see what magic can transpire. So Achrekar asked Sachin to practice hard, and that has really transpired. No? It has had a drastic change on Sachin. If you practice hard enough, one day, people from across the world would come and watch you play. So these are the words which were said by Achrekar to Sachin Tendulkar. See, the above words were the golden sermon for Sachin from Achrekar. So Sachin took all these words to his heart. These words transformed Sachin's mental courage and made him practice very hard. So these words made Sachin practice very hard and become a world-class cricketer. So definitely he had become a world-class cricketer. So without Achrekar, Sachin would not be the cricketer he turned out to be. Without Achrekar, definitely Sachin wouldn't have become this much good. And finally, my dear children, you have to write a moral. See, practice maketh a man perfect. So dear children, when it comes to the cycle test, when a paragraph is asked, you have to write everything. You can write, of course, with your own words. Okay. You can, this is just to guide you. You can use your creative words and you can write. But the things to be followed is what? In the beginning, you have to start the paragraph with the title, author, and the theme. Then your paragraph, in between, you have to add some textual quotes. Textual quotes are very important. And in the end, you have to give a moral. Okay? A moral is the same you can give, or anything pertaining to this lesson you can give. It's your choice. You can be very creative because this is English. You'll needn't memorize anything. Okay? You can write it by yourself. Only one thing is very important. You have to write it without any grammatical error. Okay, y'all can write it, of course, by your own. If there are grammar error, definitely you will lose a lot of marks. That's also there. Okay, question number 2. Narrate in your own words. See, the question itself is to narrate in your own words. If you learn this, it is my words. Okay, you have to narrate it in your own words that the hardships underwent by Sachin to become a great cricketer. Once again, see him. Title, learning the game. Author, Sachin Tendulkar. Theme, hardship of a cricketer. Sachin Tendulkar in his autobiography says that Achrekar was the man who shaped his cricketing career. Yes, Sachin always says that Achrekar is the one who has shaped his cricketing career. If it was not Achrekar, Tendulkar wouldn't have imprinted his marks in the history of cricket. Without Achrekar, Sachin is nothing in cricket. Ajit took Sachin to Achrekar's camp when he was 11. When did Ajit Tendulkar take Sachin Tendulkar to Achrekar's camp? When he was 11 years old. There was never quiet enough time for the pockets to dry. So Sachin was finding everything very hard, right? His pocket never dried at all. See, as a child, he had only one set of cricket gloves. One set of cricketing gloves he had. This is one of the hardships which he has faced, right? His routine was to wash his clothes as soon as he had returned from the morning practice session. When he comes back from the morning practice session, he used to wash the clothes. In his first year of Sharda Ashram, he played 55 practice matches during the summer break of 60 days. So during the summer camp, he has played 55 practice matches out of 60 days. So this is also very hard, my dear children. His summer session used to start at 7:30 a.m. and ends at 4:30 p.m. Early morning, 7:30, the summer session will start and it ends at 4:30. His evening session would start at 5 p.m. after 30 minutes break. From 4:30 to 5 will be an half an hour break. After that, once again, from 5 p.m. it starts. Okay? Between 5 and 7 p.m., he would have 5 more net sessions. 5 practice net sessions he used to play. After the practice, Sachin would be exhausted by the end of the day. After the practice is over, he will be totally dry. Okay. The act of conductors embarrassed him in the bus. What happens in the bus? The conductors, when they are very rude to him, he feels very shame. So this is also one of the hardships. It was all great learning experience. But Sachin did not treat anything as hardship. He only treated everything as a learning experience. Okay. The moral is hard work never fails. Okay. Now I want you all to take a look at these 2 paragraphs. If you all have any doubts, you all may post it. Make it fast. This is paragraph number 1 for you. Quickly go through it. Then I will change to paragraph number 2. Because already they have been shared to you all. All right, question number two. Just have a look at it. You can write it by your own. Once again, I'm telling the same words. You can write it by your own. Only thing is what? You have to not commit any grammatical error. Imprint means what? Imprint means carving, creating history. Print means what? Coming for a golden sermon. Sermon means what? A speech which is provided. A speech which is given in the religious places, right? Okay, I hope you all have completed it. So let's move on to the next one. So dear children, so there is another paragraph which is given here. See here, quote the sentences which you find most inspiring from the learning the game. How do they inspire you? So what were the sentences which have inspired you? See here, title, learning the game. Author is Sachin Tendulkar. The theme is the part which inspired me. Which part has inspired me? So this is my work. So it is going to be the inspiration of myself. You can take your own inspiration and you can write, or you can just formulate this and write. See here? The sentences which I found most inspiring from learning the game are, we need proper career orientation. Yes or no? Proper career orientation. So Sachin said, no, we need proper career orientation. It is definitely very important for every one of us, my dear children. Your personality plays an important role in choosing the type of career you want. It is your personality. Your career has to be matched with your personality. It has to be very important, my dear children. Choose something you enjoy and really want to do. So you have to choose something which is enjoyable and really you want to do. Not by any force, my dear children. Nobody can force anything within your mind. And you will be successful. Definitely, then only you're going to be successful. It is really true. We should be very careful in choosing our career. For what we should have proper career orientation from the seniors, like our parents, teachers, specialists, and friends. So we have to have proper career orientation. If you want to become a doctor or an engineer or an IAS officer or a journalist, you can take help from your parents, teachers, specialists, and friends. But the deciding authority must be you. Got it? You can get advice from your parents. You can get suggestions from your teachers or from the specialist or from your friends. It is going to groom you. Once you set your goal, you should not get deviated from that. You have to love your goal. That is very important. Along with that, we should enjoy whatever we do. So we have to do everything with full utmost enjoyment, my dear children. Otherwise, life will become a tragedy. Definitely, life is going to become a tragedy. I don't like to become an MBBS doctor, but my parents forcibly push me into that. If you think like that, you're not going to be happy at all. If you don't love your profession, what are you going to do? Even though there may be a few difficulties occurring in that, we can manage it with confidence. Nothing is easy, my dear children. There will be a lot of difficulties. But it is us, with the confidence, we are going to reach the goal. Okay? It's not that easy, but we have to strive towards our goal. So that is what which is given here. So with this, we come to the end of the question answers and the works which are given there. The book, prose one is done for you. So there is memory poem. Okay? Stopping by Woods on a Snowy Evening. By this time, you should have by heart in there. So there is a homework based on that. So definitely it will be shared in the classroom by principal ma'am. So you are going to read and write all the 16 lines. There are 4 stanzas, my dear children. It is very important. While writing the memory poem, there are only one rule. You have to give a title and the name of the poet. If the title and the name of the poet is not there, I will just strike out the memory poem which you have been writing and I will give only 0 marks. Because title and the poet's name are very important. Okay? I hope everything is clear for you all, my dear children. Thank you very much. Have a great day.